Gentiles the glorious riches of this mystery ordinance, which is Christ in you. Say your name. The hope of glory. And so I have come by the grace of God on behalf of the ministry of the mystery of the gospel of Jesus Christ. It's a mystery how a girl barely 14 could conceive a child by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit and 9 months later give birth to the Son of God. It's a mystery that in his name the blind see and the lame walk. Are you here today? It's a mystery that the Word was made flesh and walked around in the midst of us. If we who gather here are to flow in the ministry of the mystery of the gospel of Jesus Christ, we must first, somebody say first, zealously dissuade ourselves of the theology of empire. Are you here today? Are you still here? In the theology of empire, wealth is revered above compassion. Are you still here? And in the theology of empire, reason is exalted above holiness. Can you really say holiness?
Jesus Christ, by the will of God,
see, by the will of God is Jesus Christ. What is not a mystery is why he called you. In Baltimore in 2018, 309 people were murdered. In Baltimore, there were 385 rapes. In Baltimore, we got 67 churches, but there were 5,893 robberies. Are you still here? We who gather here in 2019 fear no evil. There is an apostolate being born in whom the gospel is uncompromised, for whom the church is unintimidated. In this emerging apostolate, the priesthood, that's you, is uncorrupted by the culture. Are you still here? In 2019, there is only one power that can terrify the devil and effectually cast him out. It is the ministry of mystery. Jesus Christ. What is it? Christ in you. The whole glory. To flow in this apostolate, you've got to be all in. Mind and body. All in. Spirit. Institutionalized Christianity. Put your hands on your heart. Ordinate. It's the revelation of the authentic, mystical body of Christ in the earth realm. You just have to ask, is it me? You have to ask, am I the one?
Is Christ in us?
Are you still here? It seems that we are all overflowing in the power of the mystery of the ministry of Jesus Christ. So on today, I have come alongside Paul to remind us who Jesus is.
Jesus Christ, that Jesus is the mystery to God of the mysteries. You can be saved. You don't have to leave here today as an unsaved person, as a person unsure of your salvation. You can leave here today knowing that you're saved.
Especially when he or she administers the Holy Communion, They not authority. They exist in the office of a local deacon in the church of God, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let the church say,
Amen.
Take not authority. They exist in the office of a deacon. The church of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, let the church say,
Amen.
Take our authority to execute the offices of a deacon, the church of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, let the church say,
Amen.
Take our authority to execute the offices of the deacon in the church of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and the church say,
Amen.
Take the oath of authority to execute the offices of the deacon in the church of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and the church today.
Amen.
Take the oath of authority to execute the offices of the deacon in the name of the Father, take our authority. Offices of the deacon in the church of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and the church today.
Amen.
Take our authority to execute the offices of the deacon in the church of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and the church today.
Amen.
Take our authority to read these scriptures and preach the same church of God in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit and the church of God. Take our authority to read the scriptures and to preach the same thing the church has come. In the name of God and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit and the church today.
Amen.
Take our authority to read the scriptures and to preach the same thing the church has come. In the name of God and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit and the church today.
Yeah.
Scriptures
And in the mind of the real world of the same, consider how superior you ought to be. In reading earlier descriptions and in training in the manner of ourselves and of the man that specifically takes to you, according to the rules of the same descriptions, and for this self-saving all, how you ought to say things and satisfy as much as you may over your ears and expectations. You have that, we have that, the hope that you have. All you need and conquer these things with which thought long before this time, and that you have daily determined by God's grace to give yourself to this process whereby it is his sweet God calling you, so that as much as God is in you, you will align yourself only to this, only this one thing, and draw all your cares and studies this way. And that you will continually pray, God, the Father, God, by the mediation of the Holy Spirit, by the mediation of our Uncle, his only Savior, our only Savior, Jesus Christ, of the miraculous assistance of the Holy Spirit, that by daily reading and weighing the scriptures, you may wax right and stronger in your ministry, that you may make so, every other source of. From time to time, assisted by the lives of you and the rules, and fashions of that and the rules and doctrines and timelines, that you may make the old son and God make example and pattern for the people to follow. And now, that this is present on my church timelines, here's the hope they may also understand your mind and will in the deepest things. And then this is what must make the world move you to do your duties. You shall shed extremely to the deepest things which we, in the name of God and his church, shall stand in the touching the same. Do you think in your heart that you are truly called according to the will of the Lord Jesus Christ? To order my title in the church. Your answer should be, I do this willingly. Are you persuaded that the Holy Scriptures dictate sufficiently all doctrine required necessity for your eternal salvation through faith in Jesus Christ? Are you determined out of that said scripture to instruct the people to commit to your church and teach nothing as required of necessity to salvation that you shall be persuaded and be conducted and approved by the scripture. Your answer should be, I am so persuaded and am so determined by God's great grace.
To the knowledge of the same, lay aside the study of your world.
sustain me, I will help. The Lord will be my help.
I will.
Will you be diligent? Will you be diligent to free the finances of yourself and your family according to the doctrine claims to be both yourself and live as much as time is in you? Holy examples and evidence of our marketing. Your answers should see me. I shall supply myself there too. The Lord will be my help.
So that
your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lived and reigned with you in unity with the Holy Spirit, world without end, and the people of God say, Amen. Preach the word of God, and to the denizens of all sacraments and congregations.